Hello students, today I, Swati Verma, assistant professor at School of Medical and Allied Sciences, Galgodias University, shall be discussing with you about molecular blotting and probing techniques. So in this particular lecture, we will discuss about what are molecular blotting techniques, what are various types of blotting and probing techniques. So let's start. So first, if we talk about molecular blotting, then your molecular blotting is a technique in which nucleic acids, that is your RNA and DNA, ribonucleic acid and your deoxyribonucleic acid or proteins, are transferred onto a specific membrane. So in this particular technique, what we do, we will transfer your RNA or DNA to a specific membrane. Now this membrane may be your nitrocellulose, your polyvinylene difluoride or your nylon membrane. So we have different types of your membrane, that can be your nitrocellulose membrane or your nylon membrane, on which we will transfer our RNA or DNA. Now this membrane can be done after the gel electrophoresis by transferring the molecules from the gel onto the surface of the blotting technique. Further, the work of this membrane is done after the by the process of your gel electrophoresis, where by means of gel we will perform a separation of your charged molecules. We will separate our substances. So by transferring the molecules from the gel onto a surface of a blotting membrane. But sometimes it can be done by directly transferring the molecules onto the membrane. After that, we can visualize these molecules by staining. So basically, in case of blotting technique, we will transfer our DNA or RNA molecules onto a specific membrane. That membrane can be your nitrocellulose membrane, your PVDF membrane or your nylon membrane. Further, after the separation has performed, we can visualize that particular molecules by means of staining. Now if we talk about your first type of blotting technique, that is your Western blotting. So Western blotting is named after your W.N. Burnett. So this is your scientist who first performed your blotting techniques. So the naming of blotting techniques is on your W.N. Burnett. This method is used for the detection and analysis of protein in a given sample. It involves the following steps. So basically, in case of Western blotting technique, we will analyze or detect the protein samples. So the following steps are there. First, isolating the protein from the particular sample. We will isolate our protein from a particular sample. After that, beta-mercaptoethanol, that is BME, and sodium dodecyl sulfate, that is your SDS, is added into the protein suspension. First, we will isolate our protein molecule. After that, your beta-mercaptoethanol and sodium dodecyl sulfate is added to the protein suspension. Then protein SDS complex is placed on the top of the gel in the well. So in the well, we will place a protein SDS complex. A molecular weight marker is also loaded in one of the well in order to determine the molecular weight of other proteins. So in order to determine the molecular weight, what we do, we will load your marker in the well. After that, the samples are added in the remaining wells. So once the sample and markers are loaded, then current is passed across the gel. So once when we have load the samples and markers, after that we will pass the current across the gel. Protein will pull down to the positive poles of the well because it is tightly bound to SDS, that is your sodium dodecyl sulfate, which is your negatively charged. Movement of protein is inversely proportional to your size. So more the size, lesser will be the movement. So the movement of protein will be inversely proportional to the size. After this step, the gel is placed against a membrane and current is passed across the gel so that all the proteins are transferred onto the membrane. Then immunoblotting has to be done. After this particular separation, what we do, we will perform our immunoblotting techniques. So in this method, first We block the membrane with non-specific protein in order to prevent antibody from binding to the membrane where the protein is not present. After that, primary antibody is added to the solution. These antibodies are responsible for recognizing a specific amino acid sequence. So once we have done with the addition of primary antibody, now these particular primary antibody will recognize the specific amino acid sequence. Then we wash it to remove our unbind primary antibody, and then your secondary antibody is added. Now these antibodies are conjuncted with an enzyme and recognize the primary antibody. Now the step of washing is done to remove your unbound secondary antibody. Here chemiluminescent substrate is used for detection. So that particular chemical which is luminescent in nature, that is it produces your radiation. So that particular substrate is used for the detection. The light is being emitted once the substrate has been added and can be detected with film imager. Now what are the various applications of this particular technique? So the first application is that it is used in clinical purpose. It is used to detect specific protein in low quantity. It is used to quantifying a gene product. So these are your certain applications. Now comes to your southern blotting. So a southern blot method is generally used in case of micromolecular biology for the detection of a specific DNA sequence in DNA samples. So in case of southern blotting, what we do, we will detect the presence of DNA sequence. Southern blotting combines the transfer of electrophoresis separated DNA fragments to a filter membrane and subsequent fragment detection by means of probe hybridization. This particular method of southern blotting was named after the British biologist Edwin Southern, who first published it in 1975. Now, in case of southern blotting, which is also known as your southern blot hybridization, it immobilizes and detects target DNA fragment onto a membrane that have been size fractioned by gel electrophoresis. So in this particular technique, what we do, we immobilize and target the DNA fragments over a particular membrane which has been size fractioned by means of gel electrophoresis. This technique was first invented in 1975 by E.M. Southern. In the processor, the DNA fragments are separated onto an agarose gel and are denatured, transferred and immobilized onto a membrane. That can be your nylon membrane or PVDF membrane. Following electrophoresis, the test DNA fragments are denatured in strong alkali. After that, the electrophoresis has performed and the test DNA fragments are denatured in strong alkali solution. As electrophoresis gel are fragile, as we all know that electrophoretic gels are quite fragile in nature and the DNA in them can diffuse within the gel, it is usual to transfer the denatured DNA fragments by blotting onto a durable membrane or your paper or nylon membrane to which a single standard DNA binds readily. Nowadays, a nylon membrane is commonly used. After the transfer of DNA fragments which need to be fixed to the membrane so that they cannot detach. In case of nitrocellulose paper, nucleic acid immobilization occurs non-covalently after baking for 2 hours at your 80 degree Celsius. In case of if we are using the nitrocellulose paper, then the nucleic acid immobilization occurs non-covalently after baking it for 2 hours at the temperature of 80 degree centigrade. In case of nylon membrane, either it is baking for 1 hour at 70 degree Celsius or UV radiation at 254 nanometer. In case of nylon membrane, either we can bake it for 1 hour at 70 degree Celsius or we can induce the UV radiation at 254 nanometer. Nucleic acid will bind more covalently with nylon membrane after UV radiation for 5 minutes. Now, your UV radiated cross-linking is basically based on the formation of cross-links between the T residues in the DNA and the positively charged amino groups on the surface of nylon membrane. So the UV radiation cross-linking is basically between the T residues in the DNA and positively charged amino groups on the surface of nylon membrane. The individual DNA fragments will become immobilized on the membrane at positions which are a faithful record of the size separation which is achieved by gel electrophoresis. Following the fixation step, the membrane is placed in a solution of labeled, that is radioactive or non-radioactive RNA, single-stranded DNA band or oligodeoxynucleotide, which is complementary in sequence to the blood transferred DNA band or bands to be detected. Since this labeled nucleic acid is further used to detect and locate the complementary sequence, it is called probe. So that particular nucleic acid which is used for the detection is known as your probe. The probe is allowed to hybridize to its complementary single-stranded target DNA sequence on the membrane. After hybridization, the reaction has been carried out. The membrane is then washed extensively to remove non-specifically bound probe. If the probe is radioisotope labeled, then the membrane is exposed to a photographic film. So if your probe is radioisotope labeled, then that particular membrane is exposed to the photographic film. Now for more information, you can mail me on this particular mail ID. Thank you.